This might be one of the sadder things I'll ever say on this YouTube channel. My podcast co-host of 3 years, Chance, was told by me that he should quit Notion. If you wait to the end of this video, I'll tell you the redemption story that he has with Notion. But first, let me get into why I told him to leave. So Chance had been working in this TTP hub that I've made before and that you guys have seen in multiple videos for about a year. I came out with this great template and he had been already using Notion for a year prior to that. And he got to the point where he just straight up told me, hey, I don't think I can do this anymore. I don't think it works for me. And while I love the way that this looks and that it really seems that it is a great and organized system, I just don't think I can do it anymore. And I want to articulate in this video the reason why it's important to know that this is okay. He had been using Notion for a long time, and this is something I talked about in a previous video, but if you're going to focus on the things like aesthetic and whether you like the application, you're gonna have to decide what actually works. So for example, I was doing this system all for myself, but also with a little bit of his preferences catered because he had been working with me for a long time. We were going to be on the same team essentially, and I wanted to see what I could get out of not only my system, but a joint system. And long story short, he ended up getting to the point where the friction was so high that he actually was becoming less productive than he would like. For reference, in the fall of 2020, I sat Chance down and showcased to him all these great things like Google Calendar, the concept of time blocking, task batching, and then ultimately Notion. He really gravitated towards this software immediately and found it very useful and enjoyed the fact that he was learning different things of how to like organize the data on a screen because he had been such an analog user for a long time. The man would literally write down all the different notes he had physically. He would have checklists that way all scattered across his desk with post-it notes. And then I introduced him to Notion and he was thrilled. The crux of the problem was, I don't think he ever really fully enjoyed the task management side of Notion, which is something that definitely can be problematic. You don't really get recurring tasks on Notion. While I do have a video on how to do that in make.com, you're not really able to do it as well as you'd like. Even recently on Twitter, something happened where there were some leaks to some recurring task references at an in-person conference that Notion had, and then magically all of those tweets got deleted within a few days. And I'm just saying that would probably mean that the product doesn't want us talking about it because, you know, they can't promise that it'll come soon, and they know that it is something that people have wanted for a long time. Chance's frustration with Notion got to the point where he just wasn't working on what he needed to when he had to. He even stopped using Google Calendar as much as he should have because the friction between all the different systems just was too great. And I sat down with him and basically said, you should quit Notion and just use ToDoIst. That's right, a Notion coach and consultant told his best friend, don't use Notion. And the reason for this is that the friction that he had mentally was just too high for it. It's something that is subliminal and cannot be understated how it can't be quantified, it can't be figured out. It's esoteric or something. You just can't figure out why some things don't work for some people. So I straight up just told him, just quit Notion, switch to ToDoIst. And what ended up happening, going back to the main story that I said I'd get back to, was that he ended up working in ToDoIst for basic task management for the last 3 months, and now recently he's gravitated towards Notion for note-taking and some of the stuff that it's better for knowledge management-wise, because you can't track things in ToDoIst like you can in Notion. Well, for example, if you look at my system, it has this task stuff. It also has things like meal planners and book libraries that you just really can't do in an app like ToDoIst. And while he appreciates the fact that ToDoIst can do these different things like recurring tasks and adding very specific and easy quick adds, like for example, if I press like Alt Q here, it'll just very easily bring up this. And that's just so convenient to him that he can't get away from that from a task management perspective. But he also understands that having a workflow with knowledge management is really important too. Who would have thought I told somebody to quit Notion? Because as much as I try to claim that I'm a little biased in these videos, which I kind of am, I told my best friend to quit Notion. So if you ever think I'm overly biased, I feel like I have a bit of a counter argument. But something that you can't argue with is that this video is going to help you increase your productivity. I mean, it's just impossible to argue with that.